Dear children, before we read this lesson, here is a question. Look at the map of Andaman and Nicobar Island given here. Now, read the sentences below. Rewrite the incorrect ones after correcting the mistakes. So, there are 6 statements given. Among these 6 statements, 2 statements are correct and the 4 statements which are not correct have been corrected for you. Today we are going to learn the second chapter in your book Honeydew. The name of the chapter is Tsunami. The tsunami is a very large and powerful wave caused by earthquakes under the sea. On 26 December 2004, a tsunami hit Thailand and parts of India, such as the Andaman and Nicobar Islands and the Tamil Nadu coast. Here in this lesson you will get some stories of courage and survival told by the eyewitnesses as well as the survivors. So the first story in the lesson, the tsunami, is about Ignatius. Ignatius was the manager of a cooperative society in Kachal Island. His wife woke him up at 6 a.m. because she felt an earthquake. Ignatius carefully took his television set off its table and put it down on the ground so that it wouldn't fall and break. Then the family rushed out of the house. When the tremor stopped, they saw the sea rising. In the chaos and confusion, 2 of his children caught hold of the hands of their mother's father and mother's brother and rushed in the opposite direction. He never saw them again. His wife was also swept away. Only the 3 other children who came with him were saved. The next story of bravery of Sanjeev, a policeman who somehow managed to save himself and his family. But when he heard the cries for help from the wife of his guest house cook, he jumped into the water to rescue her, but they were both swept away. Another story of survival is the story of Meghna, who was only 13 years. She was swept away along with her parents and 77 other people. She spent 2 days floating in the sea, holding on to a wooden door. 11 times she saw relief helicopters overhead, but they did not see her. She was brought to the shore by a wave and was found walking on the seashore in a daze. Almas Javed was 10 years old. She was a student of Carmel Convent in Port Blair, where her father had a petrol pump. Her mother Rahila's home was in Nankori Island. The family had gone there to celebrate Christmas. When the tremors came early in the morning, the family was sleeping. Almas's father saw the sea water recede. He understood that the water would come rushing back with great force. He woke everyone up and tried to rush them to a safer place. As they ran, her grandfather was hit on the head by something and he fell down. Her father rushed to help him. Then came the first giant wave that swept both of them away. Almas's mother and aunt stood clinging to the leaves of a coconut tree, calling out to her. A wave uprooted the tree and they too were washed away. Almas saw a log of wood floating. She climbed onto it. Then she fainted. When she woke up, she was in a hospital in Kamorta. From there, she was brought to Port Blair.
The little girl does not want to talk about the incident with anyone. She is still traumatized.
In the tsunami part 1, we find the brave sacrifice of Sanjeev, the policeman, and the survival stories of Ignatius, Meghna, and Almas Javed. Nankori Islands is in the central part of the Nicobar Islands chain in the Northeast Indian Ocean. Comprehension check. Say whether the statements are true or false. Now it is done for you. Please go through them. First statement is true. Second statement is false. Third statement is false. And fourth and fifth statements are true. Next, the question is, when he felt the earthquake, do you think Ignatius immediately worried about a tsunami? Give reason for your answer. Which sentence in the text tells you that the Ignatius family did not have any time to discuss and plan their course of action after the tsunami struck? The answer is, Ignatius did not immediately worry about the tsunami. He put the television set off the table and rushed out with his family because he expected only an earthquake. They were surprised to see the sea rising after the earthquake. The people were confused. They could not decide what to do in the chaos. Two of his children, along with his wife, father-in-law, and brother-in-law, rushed in the opposite direction and never came back. The sentence in the page number 25, when the tremors stopped, they saw the sea rising. In the chaos and confusion, two of his children caught hold of the hands of their mother's father and mother's brother and rushed in the opposite direction. Proves that the family did not expect a tsunami. The next question is, which words in the list below describe Sanjeev? In your opinion, look up the dictionary for words that you are not sure of. And the words are given: cheerful, ambitious, brash, brave, careless, heroic, selfless, heartless, and humorous. And you have to find out the correct word and place them in the blanks. And the answer is done for you. Please go through it. The next question is, how are Meghna and Almas's stories similar? And the answer is, Meghna and Almas's stories are similar because they were the only survivors of their families. Both of them saw their family members being swept away in front of their own eyes. They were traumatized after these incidents and afraid of talking about this incident to anyone. Dear students, hope you liked the video. This is the end of the part 1. We will continue with part 2.